Hi everyone, my name is Adam McIntosh and welcome to our overview of purchase requisitions within Moniroo for Business Central. So just before we get started, I want to take you through a quick agenda. So we're going to be walking through how to create purchase requisitions within Moniroo. So that's our online tool for Business Central. I'm going to walk you through both an inventory-based requisition and one that is strictly for the GL. We'll also take you through and just at least chat about some of our approval workflows because we have a number of different workflow options for approvals. And then last but not least, as we're doing that, we're going to walk through a lot of the configuration options as well. So we have options to restrict accounts, view budget information, restrict the pricing on the PO as well that's used. One of my favorites is actually linking the PO lines to a payment method. And many, many more options like recalling and printing documents. So we're going to walk through all of those today. All right, so let's go take a look. Okay, so here I am logged into Moniroo as one of my test employees, and I'm on the purchase requisition page, which can be accessed via the shopping cart icon on the left menu pane here. I've filtered my screen just for my saved, rejected, and documents that are awaiting approval, and you can just enable that by clicking on this filter icon at the top. As you can see here, you can filter on status, the dates you've submitted documents, or the vendor for which the requisition is assigned. So really handy tool if you're looking for prior requisitions that you've submitted or just want to see kind of what is the status of your various requisitions. Handy, handy tool here. So this is your typical view of data that we present in Moniroo, where we've got header information shown on kind of the main screen, and then you drill into that information to view the details. So you can just drill into any document by clicking on the blue hyperlink. So if I look at document 153, I can see it here. And you can do the same thing for any of your other documents. You can also sort the data by clicking on the heading for each of them. So you can sort it ascending or descending. If I want to create a new document, it's just this new button in the top left-hand corner. So let's go ahead and create a new document. I've got document number 155 here. Now I have to enter my basic information for any PO or any requisition, that being the currency. I need to select a vendor from my list of vendors in Business Central, and then I can put in comments. So this would be a comment for my internal staff, and the external comment would be viewed by the vendor. From there, I can enter other additional information that you would typically see on any purchase order. So you have your required by date, promised by date, which are just selected from a date picker. You have your shipping method, which are all pulled in from Business Central automatically, and other various information like location and payment method. You can hide these fields by clicking on the additional fields button in the top right hand corner here, or show them by clicking on that same button. We also have an option to put a more detailed note. So sometimes people would need paragraphs and paragraphs of data or information. So we allow for a more detailed note, and that's an internal note as well. You can attach this purchase requisition to the dimensions. I just click the dimensions button to display that. So department and customer group are dimensions that in this sample environment of Business Central as well. And you can see we've got a few other pieces of information. So again, just clicking these buttons to display or hide them. I can show the vendor address information that this PO is going to be sent to. And again, that can be edited as you need. Some folks will even have attachments for their purchase requisitions, and it's your standard attachment window where you browse and select a file and upload it. I'm not going to show that here today because we've got a few other videos that show that standard information, or that standard process, I should say. So you can hide and display this data by clicking the standard button in the top right-hand corner here. Again, we have that feature in a lot of our other windows as well. So it's just expanding and contracting the header data. So this now has all our header information. And one thing I should mention is that header information does default down to the lines, but you can override where necessary. So at this point, let's go input our lines. So two different types of purchase requisition lines, you can have those being inventoried and non-inventoried. So the inventoried is represented by type item, the non-inventoried by type GL account. And the difference really being the GL account types just simply go to an expense GL account or hit your GL, whereas the inventoried are going to be received into inventory and affect your inventory subledger. So I'm going to show you both types here and touch on some of the subtle nuances between the two. So let's start with a GL account. So I select the type as GL account. Then obviously I have to select the account that it's going to be hitting. Here you'll see my account numbering sequence actually starts with 50,000. So it's just showing my expense accounts in this case. And that is because I have set up the Moniroo system to not show any other accounts. So you can default in the system configuration what accounts are actually showed to the user for selection. Because in many cases, you might not want to have all of your balance sheet accounts available for selection here. So I'm just going to select one. And then at that point, I can just start tabbing through. This is a line level comment for this particular line. I can also attach this purchase requisition to a job. This is completely optional. Some people don't even use the jobs module. Some do. But here, you're just selecting the job and task. And you can even get down to the planning line on that job as well if you like. In this case, I don't have any planning lines, so I'm just going to leave that blank. Okay. Oops, I clicked too fast there. All the other information is completely optional. So tax group, for example, does not have to be input. In fact, I have a number of other columns available on here, like the department, customer group, dimensions, so on and so forth. Even budget information where I can show available and outstanding budget that you can display or not display depending on the information that is important to you. So I'm going to go ahead and just enter the unit cost here, and that's pretty much it. So you'll actually notice that when I tabbed through, it set this red little icon here, and it notes that the line is over budget, because in this particular case, my budget for this account is actually zero for the year. So, and we can actually display those budget comparisons on a monthly, a quarterly, and a yearly basis. So in this case, I don't have a budget for this account, and so it's flagging that it's over budget. And my approver will actually see that it's over budget as well. Some people find this very, very handy because it's usually a good indicator if the purchase requisition is going to be approved. If you don't have budget for that particular purchase, that's probably a conversation you've had to have ahead of time with whether or not this is going to go through. So now that I've got my GL type, let's input our inventoried PO as well. So that is just type item. Now in my drop-down selection, I have inventory items being pulled from Business Central as opposed to my GL accounts. So I'll just tab through again, and this is another line level comment. I'm going to skip over the job section this time. And yeah, we'll just go quantity. It's automatically pulling in my unit of measures and my unit cost. And that's pretty much it. One thing I should note as well is the unit costs that get pulled in can also be restricted based on the vendor pricing. So you can actually set vendor pricing amounts in Business Central itself and force your POs to conform to those pre-negotiated amounts for the prices on the requisitions. That is completely optional. It's up to you. Some people really, really enjoy that feature because it makes sure that the POs and the requisitions are correct from the very beginning. For other folks, it's additional information that they need to maintain that's just not valuable to them. Another feature we also have that a lot of people love is being able to tie this particular purchase order to a payment method. Now, I didn't show that to you here, but what that allows for is once the PO is approved and fully received and invoiced, the invoice will see that that particular PO line had a payment method associated with it and will automatically pay that invoice via that payment method. Again, some folks really, really like this because once they put in the PO and they know the approved invoice is attached to it, they know it's going to get automatically paid. So it's really, really simple, and they don't have to really think about it ever again. Other folks want to manage that once the invoice comes through. So it's really a matter of preference, and so your accounting department would have to determine what works best for them, okay? But at the end of the day, this is all configurable, and we can really enable or restrict access to whatever your company needs. So now that I've saved this, let's go ahead and submit the document. It's going to give me a couple prompts here, but document number 155 was successfully submitted. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to log out, and I'm going to log back in as my supervisor to see what they see. If I ever needed to and ever made any mistakes before I want my supervisor to view it, I can always right-click on that document and recall it if I so choose. And I can also review the approval history to see kind of who's viewed it, who's approved it as it's going through that approval process. So I'm going to stop my video here, and I'm going to come back as my supervisor. All right, so here I am logged in as a supervisor to my approval hub, and I'm drilled down on just my purchase requisitions. So we can see document number 155 that we just worked through and just submitted here. So I can see all the same information that this particular person had input. In this case, I can go ahead and edit the document if I so choose. Now again, that's a configuration setting. I can reject the document, approve it, or even reassign it to another individual should I not feel comfortable or not able to approve this document. We have a number of different options for approvals. Now, this particular system uses your standard supervisor-based approval, which is just an approval chain where documents flow to one supervisor, and each supervisor has a dollar approval limit. But we can tie approvals to various groups of people, departmental chains. We even have various thresholds over dollar amounts where we can get multiple approvers, project managers, and even final approvers for documents to flow through some sort of admin. Now, I'm not going to go through all of those in detail, as we have documentation on those elsewhere in the system. But in this case, I'm just going to go ahead and approve the document. And you can see the document was successfully approved. In this case, it was below this person's dollar limit. So now I'm going to go into Business Central and take a look. Okay, so here I am in Business Central to find my purchase orders. I just search on purchase orders. Let's sort our list, and we'll see here, there's the Fabricam vendor that we just created that purchase requisition for in that amount of $15,95.68. So you can see these documents go directly into Business Central automatically, and now I can view that document and receive that document, take any actions I wish. Okay. And there's our two detailed lines. So that's it. That's all we had for you today. So I'm just going to do a quick recap now. All right, so let's quickly recap before we get finished here. So as you saw, we were able to put in requisitions through the online portal of Moniroo, automatically linked to Business Central. I showed you a couple different types. Number one, the inventory type, as well as number two, GL-based, which would be non-inventory-based requisitions. You can optionally tie your requisition to a job as well if you like. And we walked through a number of the configuration options. So that being restricting the accounts that one can use when it's tied to a GL account. We saw some budget information on the far right-hand side of the window. We can restrict the pricing levels, and I didn't really explicitly show that, but we can configure that in Business Central and link it to Moniroo to effectively restrict the prices you can put on that PO. We can link payment methods as well, and that's actually a really great feature, because when that purchase requisition gets transferred into a PO, it carries that information over, and then once the receipt and invoice is matched against that PO, a payment is automatically triggered. So you don't really have to think about it from a back office perspective. You just know that that's been taken care of. We can recall documents. We can print documents based on your configuration. And last but not least, we actually even have options within Moniroo to send the documents into Business Central as a requisition, as an approved requisition, I should say, to allow for buyer consolidation of all those approved requisitions. Now, I didn't show that today per se, but that is an option should you need it. So if you did like this video, we really thank you for joining us. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel, and please like this video as we have more great content on the way. Thank you.